tonight, it's a community still living in fear of sex attacks. We hear from two fathers who chased and captured a teen suspect. Walking the line ahead of new laws, check out the tests suspected drugged drivers will face. And the traditional smoko break is under threat. We'll talk about how the bosses can call the shots in these tough times. Welcome to TVNZ News at 8. Thanks for joining us also tonight. It had razor-sharp teeth and a taste for T-Rex. Why a fossil find is exciting scientists right around the world.
And the first of two raw fronts out of the Antarctic has made its way to south and packed with snow showers. The wintry system is making its way north, and I'll have the details within the hour.
Kia ora, good evening. Police and Māori wardens are patrolling the South Auckland suburb of Mangere tonight, where it's feared a serial sex offender is still lurking. That's despite a teenager's court appearance over a sex attack. Police won't say if the 14-year-old is linked to other recent sexual assaults in the area, but he was chased and captured by a group of fathers who heard a woman screaming for help. Hayden Jones met two of them today.
Leela Crichton was cooking dinner when he heard a sound he'll never forget.
We heard one of the ladies screaming for help, and then we saw the car just took off from there, and it started running through the alleyway.
He sprinted out the gate and down the alleyway.
When we find him, I have to run hard to get him. Otherwise, he cannot be out there forever.
Right. They've been living with the threat of a sexual attacker over the fence for a few weeks now, so when they caught the 14-year-old, they took him into this lunchroom, they called the police, then they started to want answers.
We gave him a few questions and he come with different answers.
George Sealer, who's a new father, also helped out. It's the second time in 7 days he's given chase after an attack.
And I saw this fella grabbing the girl. She's like pulling your jacket. She started crying. And we ran after him, but he took off.
George was one of the first on the scene after an 8-year-old was raped in front of her 6-year-old sister.
The little girl is crying about it.
The 14-year-old appeared here at the Manukau Youth Court where, in front of friends and family, he entered no plea to one charge of indecent assault. The big question, though, is he responsible for the other three attacks? Well, the police are giving us no answers.
Yesterday's attack happened at the same time in the same place as the others. Is it the same guy?
We have an open mind, and it's too early to say at this stage.
In the meantime, Ngāiwi Primary School is learning to deal with the threat on its back doorstep. Māori wardens are patrolling its surrounds, and kids this afternoon were escorted home. People here are still fearful.
That report from Hayden Jones. A new group tackling organised crime had its first big bust today. The Organised and Financial Crime Agency, or OFCANS, arrested 14 people on 160 charges relating to methamphetamine after raids on members of the Tribesman motorcycle gang in Northland and Auckland this morning. The organisation is made up of police, customs, the Ministry of Fisheries, correction staff, the Serious Fraud Office and the Ministry of Social Development. Well, joining me now from our Wellington studio is Richard Short, the strategy and liaison manager for OFCANS. Richard, first of all, a pretty good start to the organisation with today's bust.
Good evening, Greg. Yes, it was. We're very pleased with the results so far.
Why is an organisation like this needed?
OFCANS gives us the ability to focus full-time on organised crime issues, and government decided some time ago that full-time focus was needed to ensure that we made sure that serious and complex organised crime was addressed in the most appropriate manner by as many government agencies as we could bring to that particular problem.
So when you say all these agencies are involved, have you got somebody at the head of it who liaises with all these people, or there are people from each of these departments who are assigned to OFCANS and that's their job?
As each piece of operational work unfolds, we talk to our partner agencies about what they might be able to contribute to that particular piece of work, and it will depend on the nature of those bits of work. In some cases, we'll have officers or staff from those agencies working directly with us. In other cases, they will simply be operating in a liaison capacity with our officers. It will just depend on the work we're doing at the time.
How much of the focus of OFCANS is about the making and selling of pee?
Methamphetamine is clearly one of the key commodities that organised crime groups are wanting to make money out of at the moment. And so our targeting of particular organised crime groups will no doubt in many cases bring us into contact with those manufacturing and distributing methamphetamine within New Zealand.
This is an enormous battle that, of course, police have been fighting for some years now. Realistically, Is it something that can ever be wiped out at this stage, or can we only control it?
We always hope that we can get to a point where people will be discouraged from engaging in organised crime. And we will keep working towards that goal at every opportunity. Certainly discouragement is one of the main elements of what we are trying to do, and with the new powers that are recently coming into play through Parliament, we think we're going to have a pretty good opportunity to do that.
Aside from the manufacture and selling of methamphetamine, what other areas are you sort of hoping to focus on with Offcans?
Well, organised crime, Greg, will aim to make money and profit out of any illegal commodity in a range of illicit markets. So at this stage, as I earlier indicated, the methamphetamine is one of the key commodities, but we know organised crime groups also engage in taxing of other criminals, using violence to extort money from them or from members of the community. We know that they may also be involved in illegal poaching of fisheries resources. They may also be involved in intellectual property crime, essentially anything they can make money out of that sits within those illegal markets. So we think we'll probably be encountering all of those things.
Presumably, by the nature of work you're going to be undertaking, there's going to be a fair amount of undercover sort of work involved in this type of organisation. Is that right?
I think that'll be one of the techniques we call upon, yes.
We heard from I can't recall the gentleman's name at the moment, but an Australian a crime expert from Melbourne just about 10 days ago saying that we are fairly naive to think that the whole sort of underbelly scenario wasn't going to come here, that sort of underworld of crime, if not already here, is going to. Do you agree with that, and how much of a part is your organisation going to play in stopping that happening?
Well, I think what you see from the creation of an organised crime agency is an acknowledgement that we know we have an organised crime issue in New Zealand that we need to deal with. We've known that for some time, and various agencies have been working quite steadily towards addressing those organised crime issues. By bringing us all together under an umbrella of an agency like Offcans, I think we can add additional impetus to that particular battle, and can help us focus on what is important in trying to discourage that sort of activity.
All right, Richard, thank you very much for your time. Richard Short, Strategy and Liaison Manager for the New Zealand Organised and Financial Crime Agency. Meanwhile, police have begun training for new powers to deal with drugged-up drivers. From next week, those behind the wheel, suspected of being under the influence of drugs, will be forced to take an impairment test. Reporter Lisa Davies got an exclusive look